if a smart meter had a nose? Well, I guess this one does, doesn't it, Sandeep? Why don't you tell us what we're looking at and what you're holding?
Sure. So what we've developed is a nanomaterial-based gas sensor that can detect multiple gases simultaneously. One of the applications is for smart cities and being able to understand air pollution, greenhouse gases, and all infrastructure leaks like methane gas. So our sensor, this particular one right now, has been embedded into a parking meter here. That's really what's going on. But really, it could be in a street light, it could be in a traffic light, any smart infrastructure at a city, it could be embedded in.
And we're really talking about a chip that is much smaller than a penny, right? Is the heart of this?
This is a 3x3 millimeter chip that can detect more than one gas simultaneously to the parts per billion. By the way, one parts per billion is one blade of grass on a football field. So, you know, it's super sensitive, and that's the whole goal, right? To be able to understand what those levels are at a very low level.
You see this more than in smart meters, in other applications as well, like TSA and so forth?
Absolutely. So if you think about detection and gases in general, ports of entries, you know, whether it's drugs related or explosive related from a security application standpoint, but at a home, think of air purification systems and the ability to not just detect the kind of gases like formaldehyde. You buy a new furniture and suddenly you've got headaches and your eyes are burning, and it's something as simple as, you know, the off gas that's causing the problem. Well, several things can happen, right? Either you take it to the garage and you leave it out there for a few days, and or you have an air purification system that automatically kicks in that starts cleansing the air.
Interesting. And it even is truly at a personal level with your AerBedic partnership down there, right?
Correct. So we are super excited about AerBedic. What they're doing is, as you may know, our breath is really a biomarker of so many different disorders. And diabetes is one of them. There are very specific gases that comes out of our breath that can detect blood sugar levels, whether when it's dropping or it's rising up. And so AerBedic is developing a consumer wearable product that's going to be out later in the year today that is addressing that market.
And is it the sort of thing that adds a lot of cost? Or I'd imagine at a chip level, it's not that much, is it?
No. So that's the amazing part of it, right? Our goal here is, when we designed this, it was designed for mass manufacturing in the millions. The goal there is to bring the cost down so that consumers can afford it. We want this sensors to be in anything. Basically, it needs to be a no-brainer for anything that's smart. If you have a gadget that's smart, we want a sensor like this in there, so now you give it a sense of smell, which currently it does not.
That makes sense. And then with these smart meters, for instance, you're coupling it with a data back end, right, to do some analysis, right?
Absolutely. So there's a predictive analytics that goes on in the data. So there's a cloud platform. All of the data goes up, and it's available to the public and or to folks that are interested in research and understanding human health and, you know, freeways, and you have, you know, people that are having certain disorders. Well, why is that happening? And that data will be available to those people too.
And this product is available today?
This is one of our partners is going to be deploying this. We hope that this year is going to be the big year where they'll deploy, but we have got other products for smart city applications. Smart air is another one of that, and that basically goes into street lights and, you know, poles and things like that.
So talking offline, you mentioned some really interesting human health research you're doing with these kinds of devices.
Right. So we have university hospitals and research institutions currently correlating air quality and human health. So one of the research that's currently taking place is women who are pregnant and the baby's brain development. They've actually correlated air quality or air pollutants, specific air pollutants that impact the brain development of a baby during the initial pregnancy, and issues such as autism, COPD, diabetes, obesity are being linked to the air that we are breathing. And so their goal right now is to really understand who these bad actors are, what are the gases that are really doing the damage, and, you know, take action.
This could become kind of the fire sensor of the century, right?
Well, it's super exciting, right? I mean, now, you know, until now, there was no real great meaningful way to understand what is in the air and what you're breathing. We take 20,000 breaths a day, and we have no idea what's in the air that we breathe, and there are consequences. And the best part is, there is something you can do about it. If you're near a bus stop, take a few steps, and a sensor like this will tell you. You're pregnant, you don't need to be that close to the curb. Just take a few steps back.
Interesting. Yeah. Well, that's fascinating. When you get it together with analytics and apps, you can do a lot of interesting
things. Absolutely. So if you think about it this way, now, you know, imagine if someone, you know, in your family has asthma. You do Google Maps and you're about to go to a park, and the quality of air is not that great, and instead of telling you to take a different route, it says, hey, why don't you go over to Park B, which has got much better quality of air.
So it's appropriate that this week Alabama and Clemson are playing, because Sandip, that's how I understand you're going to have your fab plant for these chips, right?
That's right. From a high volume manufacturing, there's a secondary processing on our MEMS sensor where we place nanomaterials that detect very specific gases. And we've decided to go with Alabama for many, many reasons. Birmingham, we're super excited. The folks there are great. The talent is available. There's a university hospital there. There's a children's hospital there. And so we feel that, you know, this is going to be a good place for us to fabricate our sensors.
Excellent. And effectively, what you've created is really a mass spectrometer on a chip, it sounds like, right?
Not as great as one, but that is the goal. I mean, at the end of the day, if you think about an MSGC, right, it's a huge product. How do you put that on your, you know, wrist, right? So we are bringing that, basically, that level of sensitivity to, you know, a chip that's extremely small.
And the eventual goal is to get it in real high volumes, right?
Correct. I mean, our goal is, you know, we're starting off right now in streetlights, parking meters, things like diabetic, well, diabetes purposes, but it's going to be a consumer product. So any gadget that is smart, you know, our goal is to basically make it into a no-brainer where it gets embedded into it. So smartphones, wearables would be the next big thing for us.
Excellent. Well, it looks like the sky literally is the limit. So yep.
Thank you so much. Thanks.